Hello, people of this world. What we do in this video and every video is we talk about how to stay calm and centered in this situation that we're in the world, no matter what happens. We also realistically point out that there's going to be a lot of turmoil coming, for sure. And we're already starting to be aware of that. Some of us were tipped off about this ahead of time, so we've prepared for it. How have we prepared? By training in right spiritual practice, actually. What is right spiritual practice? That's what we find out here in these videos. It's very easy, very simple, but also something that isn't often practiced. So you might look around and say, wow, who else is doing this? Is anybody out there? And there may not be many out there for sure. But that is what it is, right? So there's a lot of pressure in this world now to turn towards something else that doesn't work, actually. We're very habituated to what doesn't work. Why? Because we're afraid to succeed. That's the problem. That's the big problem. I call that the continuity problem. So we are aware, as we're told very accurately on this channel, YouTube channel actually, that there would be problems coming along late February and then into March, starting to accelerate and likely really things breaking loose in March. We're aware of some of those things, aren't we, already, that are taking place. Not unexpected, right? Not unexpected. So, what I would suggest, first of all, is to realize that this is not all unexpected. We expected this, and so there are plans to sidestep troubles in various ways. The right way for everybody is right spiritual practice. How are you able to center yourself? Feel centered and not all fragmented, and feel as if your future is going to be very smooth and wonderful, actually. How are you able to do that when everybody else around you is losing their heads, is the question. It's not easy, is it? First of all, it's better if you're not around a bunch of people who are losing their heads. That's better. Why be in a situation that's really terrible for you? Terrible, like tempting to be distracted. Why? It's not good. But so that would be that's the optimal situation. Now, if you're not in that optimal situation, you have to then be very disciplined in terms of watching your thoughts, watching what's going on with you, and making sure that you continually keep practicing as much as possible. Keep paying attention as much as possible to right spiritual discourse, right spiritual practice, which means effective practice. And here we go very smoothly, very gently, very easily. We're not trying to force some kind of big breakthrough. No way. Because the continuity problem really precludes that in most cases. So we're just suggesting some easy practices. Okay, now the basis of right spiritual practice has certain understandings, premises behind it. And one of the premises is that sensory perception inherently leads us astray, inherently generates fear, inherently generates conflict, inherently generates enmity, inherently generates turmoil, conflict, troubles, inherently so, absolutely so. I call it the snake that creeps up on you. We don't realize it subtly creeps up on you, and before you know it, you're acting out of fear. Sensory perception generates this. That's its purpose, actually. And we may say, well, why did God give us sensory perception? God did not give us sensory perception. We gave it to ourselves. We are spirit, actually. We're spirit. And we have given ourselves this so-called, quote-unquote, gift of sensory perception, bodily flesh, right? The flesh. That's not a gift. It's not a gift, really. It is a problem. It is trouble. Jesus said, forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. What he's saying is, sensory perception sneaks up on us. And we're not aware of why are we so frightened? Why are we so terrified? Why do we feel a need to get things and possess things and control things and attack others and all this kind of stuff? And before you know it, we've turned into, you know, terrible, fear-driven, panicked, you know, panicked action, terrible actions, fear-based actions. Forgive them, for they don't know what they do. It's saying, look, this perception, problem with perception sneaks up on everybody. Everyone. It sneaks up on you. I was aware of it sneaking up on me, and I still couldn't stop it. You can't stop it. It sneaks up on you, but you can accept the conclusions, new conclusions, from non-physical sensory perception, from spiritual perception, which is what we call the Holy Spirit. We can accept the conclusions of spiritual perception as being true, and the conclusions that sensory perception is giving us as being false. We don't attack sensory perception. We don't attack the body. We don't try to get rid of it. Just like we don't try to get rid of our shadow as we're walking along. We just realize that's just a shadow. It's nothing. It's nothing to be concerned about. The conclusions of sensory perception are simply mistaken. That's all. And the conclusions of spiritual perception are simply true. That's all. All right? Not a big deal. It's not difficult. So right spiritual practice means orienting ourselves towards spiritual perception, which we call the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness. And right spiritual practice, in orienting us toward the vision of oneness, takes place wherever you are. Because wherever you are surrounded by appearances, right? Is there anybody who's not surrounded by appearances? You can turn around and you see there's an appearance everywhere, isn't there? You can even look up at the sky, there's the appearance of the sky. And if you're in your outer space, there's the appearance of outer space, appearance of space. So we're always surrounded by appearances. At present moment, these appearances are giving us feedback about what we think reality is like. And the feedback we're getting through sensory perception is that reality is not real. It's changed. It's based on specialness and judgment and levels and stratification and crystallization and all this. That's the meaning we're getting back from sensory perception. This is false. This is false. It's false witness. Spiritual perception will, and all the appearances that we see, they will give back this reflection of there's only this one smoothed out, vast everywhereness. And everything, all things are equally abiding in this boundlessness. And so every place is really, could be said to be the center of this boundlessness. Or you could say it has no center. I at this point, I prefer to say that everything is equally centered in the heart of boundlessness. No matter what the location is relative to this body or anything, and no matter what the quality, what the shape of the form, appearance, what the color is, what the odor is, what the motion is, what the, you know, how it feels, the texture, the solidity, the weight, the size, the density, none of that matters in the slightest bit. In terms of its meaning, true meaning, that it equally abides in the heart of boundless everywhereness. So, our spiritual practice is wherever we are, what's ever happening. And we simply need to take a moment to just do simple practices. Let's say you're in a riot, and there's going to be plenty of riots going on in the world. And you've got these activists and agitators and riots. I mean, you know, things are popping. And the fireworks displays are, you know, it's a big, big dance of turmoil. You can just take a moment and just look around you, your appearances, and just say, wait a minute. This moment as it is, meaning without any time taking place, so adding or subtracting, just exactly as it is right this instant, this moment just as it is, is the radiant reminder of the absolute eternal life of all things, absolute eternal life of all things. Okay. Is the radiant reminder of equal vision. There's many ways you can do it, but you can take just a moment, just this moment, just say, and then that's a generalized statement what I made, this moment, because there's a riot going on. You might have trouble dealing with all the activity, so you can just say, this moment, this moment, as it is a perfect witness to the perfect witness to the eternal abidance in everywhereness, is a perfect witness to the eternal abidance in everywhereness. So this practice is designed for those people who are in turmoil, conflict, riots. There are places in the world where there's a lot of agitation going on. And for instance, in a war, bullets are flying, bombs are blowing up. It's hard to take a look at a tree or bush and focus on something in particular because there's just too much going on. But you can say, this moment as it is, this moment just as it is, this moment as it is a flawless, precious witness to the total abidance in the boundless everywhereness. This moment as it is, this moment that's taking place, this moment as it is, not waiting for something to happen. You just stop, full stop right now, this moment as it is. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment as it is specialness free. Okay, so there are lots of ways you can add on. This moment as it is the beginning, okay? There are lots of ways that you can put the ending to it, all right? But first, when there's too much turmoil, you say, you know, this moment as it is a flawless witness to heart-centered abidance in the everywhereness. Now that may be too difficult because too much turmoil is going on. So you can keep it simple. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. And you no doubt will recognize that the world, this was happening, the changing of appearances, the dance of appearances, doesn't really have the power over you that you tried to give it. We've tried to give projections power over us, you know, but we cannot succeed at that. But we can try, and we can plausibly assert that it's that in the future it could happen. We can always say that. We can always say, well, you know, that's why I say just as it is. Don't let the mind say, well, better not practice this now because in a few moments it might have full power over you. You don't know. You got to use your will, okay, a little bit, and say, this moment, as it is, meaning you're not waiting. You're not saying it could change, truth could change the next moment. No, you're saying, no, just as it is, right now, this instant, just as it is, without adding or subtracting anything. Whatever it is appearing, just as it is. It doesn't have to be better, doesn't have to be worse, doesn't have to be calmer, doesn't have to be more riotous. And no change is happening at all. Just as it is, this moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness, is totally self-released from all specialness. Is totally released from all relativeness. This moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. Just discovered a greater power than your projections. You think you have that power over you, because really you're taking back the power that you tried to give away. See, we're trying to give our power away to our own projections, and you can never do this because it's a delusion. So what we have to do is take our power back. Say, okay, I'm not going to try to give my power away. I'm not going to try to disempower myself. Because I'm one with reality. So attempts to disempower ourselves are attempts to disempower reality, actually. So you say, I'm going to stop giving my power away. I'm going to say, this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This directly counters your sensory perception, what your sensory perception is telling you, subtly. Your sensory perception is telling you that everything that sees is special, that it's all different, that there's different degrees of abidance in every awareness. That is what sensory perception is telling you nonstop. It's bearing false witness. So you simply turn that around. Take your will back. Stop trying to give your power away by giving your power to sensory awareness and what it's telling you. You're trying to dispossess yourself of reality, of your power, of your will, of reality, really. Bearing false witness to reality, and therefore trying to confuse you and drive you into really eternal death is what really the goal is. You don't want that. So it doesn't matter what other people are doing or saying or thinking, because you're saying this moment as it is, meaning prior to anything shifting or changing, as it were, in this eternal instant, just as it is, it's totally free of all specialness. This is like a basic, powerful technique, spiritual practice you can use in any situation. And of course, there are going to be many situations arise in this world that you're going to need to use something very simple and powerful. And this technique itself is sufficient. All right spiritual practice is sufficient in itself to bring up to smoothly segue you into vision of one sophisticated and flowery. Sometimes we feel that way, but it can also be very concise and simple. Both ways work. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. And this is true of every moment, whatever's going on around you, right there and then, this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. You can also say, this moment as it is totally free of all historicness. This moment as it is totally free of all historicness. But I would say specialness is maybe a more abstract, powerful way of putting it. It's up to you how you feel. There's many ways you can go about it, but I would say this moment is totally free of all specialness. But different people resonate to different terminology. So you have to find something that does, you know, resonate with you in some way. Subtle resonation. Not emotionalism, it's something subtler than that. So, I'll be giving out, try and give out, we'll see how it goes, to, you know, various spiritual practices for people around the world to use in the situations that they're in, because there's a lot going on in different places of the world. They're feeling different, you know, different about stuff. Some people are in a peaceful situation. They may be able to just look at the beauty around them and practice, like, in a different way. Are the same, it's fine. It's all practices are relevant to our appearance. The appearances can be applied to any situation we're in. I just probably believe that if you're in a really intense, conflicted, turmoil situation, you need to keep it really simple, really direct. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. And you can do that as you're going along in the subway, in traffic, in hustle and bustle, shopping, all this stuff. You can just take a moment, just say, this moment just as it is totally free of all specialness. Totally free of all specialness. And you'll find that sometimes you can be more adamant about it. Sometimes it's just kind of lackadaisical, other times very adamant. So the world is thinking, what do we do for peace? Oh my gosh, where's the saviors? Where's the peace? You know, now we're frantically looking around. Everybody's looking around, you know. Who can help us? Where's the help? Where's the help? Actually, right spiritual practice is the help. And you can silently to yourself, wherever you are, just say, this moment just as it is totally free of all specialness. That is the help. That is the help. It is very simple, actually. Everybody's looking for a warrior king or something, or, you know, or a big government to come in and say, we'll help you. You know, this is the answer. It's not the answer to our real problem at all. The answer to our problem, our continuity problem, which is the only problem we really have, is the vision of oneness. That's it. That is it. How do we get there? Right spiritual practice. This moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This plaza, You might be in a plaza. This plaza, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This crowd, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This battle, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This drama, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This conflict, just as it is, right? Without any one side winning or losing, okay, no. Without any outcome, so you're not waiting for any outcome of anything. This conflict, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This panic, just as it is totally free of all specialness. So I'm just testing this out, and I'm feeling it's very powerful and very effective. So I highly recommend it to everyone around the world, actually. Because we will all be in situations, most of us will be in situations where we're going to have to use this, for sure. In fact, wherever you are, you can use it all day, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. It's like a very fundamentally powerful exercise. You see, don't get caught in trying to get the vision of oneness directly. Then you'll end up panicking. I can't get it. Why can't I get it? Well, go with the practice, the right spiritual practice. Aim a little lower. Okay, aim lower. Aim for right spiritual practice. That automatically will, in time, generalize into the dawning of the vision of oneness. It will generalize. But it's sufficient to do right spiritual practice right now. It's sufficient to keep you going in the right direction. And at some point, the generalization will automatically occur. And the vision of oneness will begin dawning upon you. And maybe there will be moments where it dawns upon you. And then you just say, wow, this works, wow. It may not, you may back away from it a little bit, but you still see it and you say, oh my gosh, this works. There really is perfect peace everywhere. Everything is already abiding in perfect peace. There's only perfect peace everywhere, always. That is a fact. Now we're trying to make something else happen. We're trying to undo creation, is what we're trying to do. And so we perceive everything, the totality. We perceive it as special. Specialness everywhere. There's no perception that we're having here with the sensory perception that doesn't perceive specialness. It's always perceiving specialness. I mean, this is closer, that is farther away, this is higher, this is lower, this is bigger, this is smaller, and perception has a judgment upon all of that. This is more useful, this is less useful, this is more valuable, this is less valuable, this is abiding in better spaciousness than that, this is more, this is less, this is duality is what we're talking about. So sensory perception is duality. But we need sensory perception here in this world for now to function. That's fine. But we don't need the meaning that it's giving, reflecting to us. We don't need that meaning. We can have the meaning that everything is equally abiding in the everywhereness. We can have that meaning, and that brings us stable, totally stable sense of identity. Just a total stability and genuine peace of mind. So that no matter what's happening, doesn't even touch it. But that's a very advanced condition. And so what I'm saying is, don't try to directly reach that advanced condition, okay? Rather, do simple right spiritual practice. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. Do that. Gradually, subtly, you become more and more comfortable with the vision of oneness, saying, you know what, that's what I really want, and it feels very right, and it's very acceptable to me, it's not a problem. Gradually that will dawn upon you, okay? So, do not aim too high, okay? That's a mistake. Aim a little lower, and that will advance you way faster, way further, way faster. This turmoil, as it is totally free of all specialness. This riot, as it is totally free of all specialness. Totally free of all specialness. This interaction as it is totally free of all specialness. This day, as it is totally free of all specialness. This gloom, as it is totally free of all specialness. This mood, as it is totally free of all specialness. This euphoria, as it is totally free of all specialness. This nationalism, as it is totally free of all specialness. This concern, as it is totally free of all specialness. This is like a miraculous practice, actually. You can't really understand how it works. But it works. I mean, I can explain it to some extent, but we really, it's amazing how it works. It has profound traction. We won't all find ourselves in beautiful, lush, peaceful surroundings based on what our karma, what our momentum has been, and various factors that seem too complex to even contemplate. But, so, we do have to get down to the bare essentials. What works under all circumstances? This one. This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. Those streets as they are totally free of all specialness. That building as it is totally free of all specialness. This news as it is totally free of all specialness. This life, as it is totally free of all specialness. That mountain, as it is totally free of all specialness. This event, as it is totally free of all specialness. You can just practice like that. But more often than not, you will find yourself in the midst of turmoil, chaotic thinking, panic thinking, various people are, you know, everybody's blah, 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 right? You may not be in a tranquil, lush place. I am, by the grace of God, am in a good, really nice locale. So that helps me be able to do what I'm doing. Now, if I was in a super, you know, stressed out war zone or something, I probably would not be able to come up with this and do what I'm doing. It would be too tough to, you know, generate the will and momentum to do this. So, pragmatically, I'm in a good situation. It could be better. Maybe it will be better soon, actually. I'm able to dispense this, share this with the world and be helpful. Because it's not easy. When you're in those tough situations, it's not easy to summon your will. Hey, it's not easy for me when I go to Trader Joe's to summon my will to practice. I forget. It's too tough. Like, too tough. How can I do this? Well, again, this moment. Just say this moment. Just this moment. Don't be specific. Sometimes it's hard to be specific starting off. This moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment, and do that, this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. And it, keep repeating that and keep doing it, and then you may be able to start being more specific. This store, as it is totally free of all specialness. Those shoppers, as they are totally free of all specialness. This food, as it is totally free of all specialness. Yeah. This noise, as it is totally free of all specialness. This place, as it is totally free of all specialness. You know, that tomato, as it is totally free of all specialness. And as you're able to get more and more specific, you will find yourself more and more centered, like, wow, I can even apply this, you know, to everything specifically in my environment right here. As you enter this shopping cart, as it is totally free of all specialness. This cash register, as it is totally free of all specialness. This bag, as it is totally free of all specialness. Although they don't give out bags there anymore. So you might not be able to do that one, but of course you can bring your own. You can use it that way. I'm a chronic forgetter of bringing bags here. They ban bags. Bags have been banned. I always forget. Habit of a lifetime, right? It's tough to break the habits of a lifetime. And that bag is a tough one. I just go into the store and say, I forgot the bag. Everywhere, it doesn't matter. No more bags. We're saving the world. No more bags. Okay. This bag ban, as it is totally free of all specialness. This money, as it is. You're handing the money. This money as it is totally free of all specialness. This muzak we're hearing. This muzak as it is totally free of all specialness. This snowstorm as it is totally free of all specialness. This cold wave, as the U.S. is getting hammered again. And again and again and again and again and again. This cold wave, as it is totally free of all specialness. Say that, you know. Mean it. This cold wave, as it is totally free of all specialness. This cold wave has no value, has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Okay, so this is something you can add on. Let's say you say this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment as it is has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. But this works a little better with specifics. So this crowd as it is is totally free of all specialness. This crowd has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. But this crowd appearance has for us. A crowd is appearing in our perception. It's actually reflecting meaning to us. And we're saying that the meaning that our sensory perception is giving this crowd appearance has zero value for us. Zero. Because it really has no meaning. It really doesn't. So it has zero value for us. Only the vision of oneness has value. This riot, as it is totally free of all specialness. This riot has zero value for me. Or just zero value. Zero value for me. You can say that too. This riot has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. And you may be in a chaotic situation, and you're able to start out with this moment, and then this crowd, and this person, this place, and you might see a little flower somewhere or something, and you just say that this flower, as it is totally free of all specialness. This flower has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. You might see a little pebble, and you say, this pebble, as it is totally free of all specialness. This pebble has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. And this will totally transform your mood. And you're in really a mini state of awe, actually. It's just, wow. Wow, what's going on? Wow. You actually have a situation going for you, which is way more interesting than any world war could possibly be. We think that global conflict, global financial collapse, all this stuff is really interesting. It's not nearly as interesting as saying this pebble, as it is totally free of all specialness. This pebble has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That is actually way more interesting to you than global World War III, tribulation, collapse of the planet, etc. Way more interesting. This other stuff actually is boring to you, to us. Absolutely it is. Very boring. It's like, here we go again. You know, here. Been there, done that, doesn't work. This is just crass, crude, boring stuff, really. Really, it's not what I really want to. It's not the meaning I really want. It doesn't give me the meaning I really want. It doesn't make my life really meaningful at all, does it? It does not. That's why it has no value. It has no value. This global war, as it is totally free of all specialness. This global war has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. And that's a fact. You're speaking fact. And you will feel it. You will feel it in yourself. Say, oh my God, this is incredible. You feel something like it's just like you're kind of like on the verge of discovering what has true value for you. Really, what you really want. You feel like I'm almost there. And that is more interesting than any world war could possibly be, right? Because that doesn't give you anything that you want, that you really want. Gives you false hope, is all it does. Waste of time. No value. There's no value there. This global financial collapse is, as it is totally free of all specialness. This global financial collapse has no value. No value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a global financial collapse problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. Only the vision of oneness resolves the continuity problem. Global financial collapse has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So what we're talking about here is what we really want. The meaning we really want to get. Only the vision of oneness gives us this meaning that we really want. That everything, all appearance, equally abides in the unbounded everywhereness. The identity of everything is not based on relativism whatsoever. No relativism. Relativism does not factor in to the fundamental fact of reality at all. Doesn't touch upon it whatsoever. We're not concerned about pragmatic usefulness. We're not trying to change that. I mean, a hammer is a hammer. It hammers nails, you know. You wouldn't use a feather fan to hammer nails or whatever. Okay, of course. From a standpoint of pragmatic usefulness, that's one level, okay, but we're not making level confusion here. We're talking about meaning, ultimate meaning, of what's meaningful. That hammer as it is totally free of all specialness, meaning all special meaning, meaning it's not proving that everywhereness is not everywhere. That sameness is not sameness. It's not proving that at all. But our perception of it gives us the impression that it is. That everything we see gives us the impression that it's proving that reality is not real. Everything we're perceiving. So we have to practice saying, no, this building as it is totally free of all specialness. This building has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. And all these figures on your television set of fighters and war and conflict and blah, 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 the talking heads on there and all the stuff that we have been through and we're so absolutely sick and tired of it. All of that just simply like fades away, it pales in comparison like a shadow. You just say, wow, that's not what I really want. It has no value. My spiritual practice is pointing to the vision of oneness, and only the vision of oneness has value. You might ask yourself, how in the world did I get to this place where I'm able to say this and put this out there? Simple. Right teachers, right teaching. That's it. And right effort. You could add that too, for sure. Right teaching. Right teachers, right teaching, right effort. But without the right teachers and right teaching, there wouldn't have been the right effort. Now, you see, you might find yourself alone in this chaotic situation, and you won't be able to find somebody to sit down in some coffee shop and chat for 3 hours about philosophy or something. You need something right now, right this instant. Just you, what can you do? This moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. See? Everyone can apply that around them. Every single person on this planet can apply that right where they are right now. We need these powerful techniques that go beyond mere discussion. We're not in some, you know, not at some seminar at Esalen, or we're not in some lecture hall of Stanford, or we're not, you know, sitting in some nice mansion by a pool chatting about philosophy or something, you know. No, we might be those places, which is fine, but, you know, we might not. So, you have to center yourself right now, this moment as it is right now, Right now, this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. Okay? Totally free of all specialness. This moment as it is has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Of course, when we say this moment as it is, we mean everything that's appearing to us. We're saying all this appearance. All this appearance. When we say this moment, whatever it is, the totality of what's appearing to us has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Because the way that we're perceiving it has no value to us, has no meaning, actually. So, you're not alone. Wherever you go, you're not alone. You're not powerless. You have spiritual techniques, spiritual practices you can use. Silently, right? You can say this silently. Nobody needs to know. You're sitting on the subway. There's all this, you know, monitors flashing, all this war news, graffiti, posters, and people, all this stuff's going on. It's like, and noise, and it's just like, you're freaking out. You sit there quietly and just say, this moment, look around, this moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. Silently, don't say that. This moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. Now, it's a fact. It is a fact that coming up, there will be many people who are suicidally depressed, many people in the world. And they'll be radiating that to you. They say, my life is futile. I cannot find any meaning. Existence is meaningless. I just want to die. You know, this is just, you know. They lack the right spiritual practice. They feel they've given all their power away. They have no will to do it. Okay, so you may feel around people who feel totally helpless, hopeless, helpless, no will, incapable of doing it, right? That can get into you. That can get you. And you catch the mood like a virus. So you just say, hey, this moment, just as it is totally free of all specialness. This moment has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. You keep saying that like your life depended upon it. Because it does. It really does. In a world that has tried to give all its power away to projections, and then have those projections attack them to prove that it's possible to give all their power away, mood is going to be very severely depressed. Of course. You don't want to get caught up in that mood. Moods are very contagious. That is what I'm concerned and pointing out to everyone, is that the most contagious thing in the world are this mood of despair and weakness and hopelessness. Very, very contagious. More contagious than any virus. Way more contagious. And people can get gripped by that. Communities, nations, the whole planet can get in the grips of that. And I expect that is something that is coming. So we need these incredible, effective, powerful techniques. This is one of them. Okay, for sure this is one of them. There certainly, I would say, are others too. Okay, this doesn't preclude any other technique or anything like that. Okay, there's nothing special about me or anything like that. I'm sure there are others, and we probably will come up with some others and pass them along for sure. There are many, many different types, but you gotta have an ace in your hand. Okay. This one is super, super, super helpful. Okay. You can take it to the bank, this one. This situation, as it is, as you're riding on that subway, this situation as it is totally free of all specialness. This situation has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. All right. 3 steps, very powerful, right? This situation as it is totally free of all specialness, okay? This situation, that's one. This situation has no value, that's two. Only the vision of oneness has value, that's three. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Knockout punch to this mood of despair. Now, the extension of this practice is beyond our capacity to measure, so don't worry about trying to measure it. Very important. Don't look for results in that way. Don't try to say, well, how much did I get? How much progress did I make? No, it actually extends beyond what we can even imagine. It's so powerful. To just let it, you know, just do it. That's all, just do it. Maybe I can get Nike to sponsor this, you know, just do it. Or maybe I can't use that, maybe it's trademarked, I don't know. But just do it, just do it, just do it. And ultimately you may find yourself in better circumstances, actually, because you said all this stuff has no value, no value, no value, no value. You want to practice more, right, spiritual practice. You may find yourself in more and more serene conditions and situations. But you got to start wherever you are. Wherever you are, this situation as it is totally free of all specialness. This situation has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So, we're going over this. This is very important. I'm aware there's a timetable. And I've been under enormous pressure to get ready for this situation. And it's coming. It's coming. The tsunami is coming. This tsunami, as it is totally free of all specialness. This tsunami has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Of course, you can say this as you're running away from the tsunami to higher ground, of course. we're not trying to be pragmatically stupid. I mean, if there's something, a bulldozer coming at you, you get out of the way. But again, as you get out of the way, keep practicing. Because we're talking about the level of meaning, okay? Pragmatically, of course, do what you need to do to get out of the way of the bulldozer, the steamroller. You know, there's a steamroller coming. It wants to flatten everything out, so get out of the way of the steamroller. But primarily stay centered in your right spiritual practice. There's nothing wrong with being, you know, pragmatic and taking care of business and etc. There's nothing, of course. But what we're dealing with here is way more profound. What we're dealing with is getting what we really want, which is meaning from what's appearing to us. Meaning. Right now we're not getting any meaning, actually. Which is why we're desperate. Which is why we're so conflicted. We're not getting any real meaning. Because the meaning of everything is the reality of it. And the reality of it is that everything is equally abiding in the everywhereness, the presence of everywhereness, the perfect presence. Everything is equally abiding in the perfect presence. That's the meaning of everything. That's reality. You can't have one thing equally abiding in it and others not equally abiding in it. That's impossible. Truth and lies are not compatible. You see, there's the mutual exclusives. If you say everything was equally abiding in something, then you cannot say, well, something is not equally abiding in it, because then the statement everything is equally abiding is invalid. It invalidates it. So truth invalidates lies. Lies try to invalidate truth. Lies are forever lies, and truth is forever true. So the vision of oneness, everything is equally abiding in the pure presence of everywhereness, everything, without exception. So So I'm sure you have an interesting situation confronting you. Everybody does. I have a very interesting situation confronting me for sure. But I can say this situation that's confronting me, this situation is totally free of all specialness. This situation that's confronting me, this future, let's say, this future that's confronting me as it is, it's totally free of all specialness. This future that's confronting me has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Now by saying that, you're literally changing the future, literally, right this moment, because you're giving no value to it. That is the one that's confronting you. You're only giving the value to the vision of oneness. That means your future will align with whatever is pragmatically helpful to achieve the vision of oneness. That's what it means. So if you're looking at despair at the future, try this. The future that is confronting me is totally free of all specialness. The future that is confronting me has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That's a stunner, isn't it? Yeah, I'm stunned by it right now. That's a real stunner. That is tremendous. So if you start feeling despair about the future right there, see, this future of despair is totally free of all specialness. This future of despair has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. This future that's confronting me is totally free of all specialness. This future that's confronting me has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So you can use this one when you get into the mood of thinking about, oh, the future, oh my God, oh my God. The other one is more like for, well, it's the same technique. I'm just using a different subject matter for it. When we're in action, see, this moment as it is totally free of all specialness. This situation as it is totally free of all specialness. It's what's happening now, right? You're confronted with it. But when you're confronted with thinking about the future, then despair and hopelessness, stuff can creep in there. So it's very important to use that and say, hey, wait, this future that's confronting me is totally free of all specialness. This future that's confronting me has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Don't let yourself get caught up in mental thinking about the future. Punch it out. Say, no value. No value to that thought. And here's another technique. When you're going along and all these thoughts start popping in your mind about that unwanted, really, that this doesn't have any value, say, no value to that thought. No value. No value. Notice it. No value. Only the vision of oneness has value. No value to that thought. Doesn't give me what I really want. Only the vision of oneness gives me what I really want. Only the vision of oneness has value. No value to that. See, you just thought, no value to that. It's off track. It's off track. No value to getting off track. There's no value to getting off track. This is trying to pull us back into judgment. All these thoughts are trying to pull us back into the judgment of perception, of the personality, of the belief system, of the ego. It's all trying to pull us back into that. There's no value in that. None. No value. There's no value. Has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That thought, no value. See, no value. No value. Thinking about the crows, no value. Stop it instantly. No value there. No value. And say, what has value? This moment as it is totally free of all specialness. Only the vision of oneness has value. Hmm. my surroundings, the surroundings are totally free of all specialness. My surroundings are totally free of all special, my surroundings as the surroundings, my surroundings as it is. I'll use the singular there, as it is, that's fine. The surrounding, these surroundings are as it is. We got a plural and a singular. It's not really important, but let me think about this. I prefer the singular, you know, I prefer the singular because it feels, you know, very simple and direct. If you say these surroundings as they are totally free of all specialness. I don't know. I'll think about that one. Say this place, and that place is includes your surroundings. Okay, let's try to keep it singular here. This place as it is totally free of all specialness. I feel better when it's singular for some reason, so let's go with that. This place, which surroundings, everything, this place, this situation, this moment, it includes everything. You can say different. This garden, this park, this city, as it is totally free of all specialness. This place, as it is totally free of all specialness. This day, as it is totally free of all specialness, so. Now you can add a, you can use a word like rocks. Let's say there's like a bunch of rocks. If you said those rocks as they are totally free of all specialness. That's plural thing. Well, you could also say that rock appearance, the appearance of those rocks as it is, the appearance of those rocks as it is. Is totally free of all specialness, or those rock appearances as it is totally free of all specialness. These are semantics. Semantics have a little influence on things. I will take this under consideration as I go along. That rock appearance, that can be plural, it could be a mountain. That mountain, that rock appearance, that tree appearance. It could be singular or plural. You could be looking at one tree, or you could look at a whole bunch of trees. I can say spacious. That grove spaciousness. That rock outcropping spaciousness. That rock spaciousness, as it is totally free of all specialness. A flock of birds. That flock of birds, as it is. You say those birds. That flock of birds, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of people, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of rocks, as it is totally free of all specialness. Bunch of trees. That group of trees. That grove of trees. That group of trees. That or this group of trees, as it is totally free of all specialness. So I'm just refining here, live, you know, just something to of interest to look at. That group of branches, those branches, that group of branches, as it is totally free of all specialness. That branch, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of branches, that tree, that group of trees, that house, that group of houses, that group of houses, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of houses has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That group of cars, that large group of cars there, that group of cars, making it singular, that group of cars, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of cars has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. That group of flowers, and many flowers, that group of flowers, as it is totally free of all specialness. That group of flowers has zero value. Only the vision of oneness has value. Or that bunch of flowers, So use, I think it's better to use a term that puts it into the singular for you. That line of rocks, or that, those blades of grass, those that expanse of lawn, that group of grass blades is totally free of all specialness. This is just extra time here. We're just doing extra time to kind of, it could be interesting, kind of a cool down time. We've gone over the real intense part of it, and this is like just, I'm sort of like trying to compose here and just trying to see between that and those. Those means separate things, right? Those, that, and that, and that, and that, those. It seems a little like a little bit diffuse, you know, a little too diffuse. And then your mind starts thinking, oh, wait a minute, is this one more than that one? Is more than that one? It's better to be singular because we're aiming for a singular vision. The vision of oneness is a vision of equal vision. The vision of singular is, it's all the same. I think it's easier to use the singular, that bunch of flowers, instead of those flowers. Your mind is then it will start thinking, oh, which one are you referring to? Or, you know, no. That bunch you're referring to, because that's what's appearing to you, a bunch of flowers. That bunch of flowers is absolutely is totally free of all specialness. That bunch of flowers that is appearing. You're seeing a bunch of flowers. That's what's appearing. That bunch. You can say this is closer. So that and this. This bunch of flowers is totally free. If you're, it's close to you. This bunch of flowers are farther away. That bunch of flowers. That group of trees over there, that group of trees, or this group of trees closer, you can use that. That expanse of sky, that group of clouds, that area of cloudiness, that area of cloudiness as it is totally free of all specialness. That area of forest is totally free of all specialness. That area of the river, that area of the sky, this area of the yard, is totally free of all specialness. This area of the city is totally free of all specialness. This area of the city as it is, I'm leaving that out, but I should put that in. This area of the city as it is totally free of all specialness. This area of the world, you could say you're someplace, say this area of the world as it is, right where you are, you're standing, say this area of the world as it is totally free of all specialness. This area of the world has no value, only the vision of oneness has value. You can do that, and you can also say this planet as it is, this planet area. This area of the universe we call the planet. This planet area of the universe, as it is totally free of all specialness. This planet area of the universe has no value. Only the vision of oneness has value. So, doing our homework here, doing our homework, smoothing it out. This area, this group, this bunch, this place, this expanse, this vast expanse of sky or space, this vast expanse of the galaxy is totally free of all specialness. This vast expanse of the galaxy has no value. This only the vision of oneness has value. Or that vast expanse, this vast, you know, this, that, singular. So see, this is the tough work. This is the tough work. This is actually difficult work. I'm just checking my reactions out to each thing I say. You know, how does it feel? And developing is developmental work here. That ivy hedge as it is, that ivy hedge as it is totally free of all specialness. That stack of cages as it is totally free of all specialness. So we can usually come up with a singular. Sometimes it's a little more difficult than others. It's just interesting here. Pebbles, like those. So that area of pebbles, that bunch of pebbles, that bunch of pebbles over there, that scattered bunch of pebbles as it is. That scattered, you see a bunch of pebbles, you walk along the trail. This scattered bunch of pebbles, as it is totally free of all specialness. This area of pebbleness, as it is totally free of all specialness. You can do that one too. Do that one too. All right, time to wrap this up. Thanks for watching, and we'll keep on working. Very great. That's it.